Hey guys, how's it going? In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you the computer vision version of the Dino game hack. And the fun part is that at the end of this tutorial, you get all the files and the code on my GitHub repository. You can leverage it. So if you are glad about this, let's go into it and start from scratch how you can hack this game using computer vision. Let's get right into it. Alrighty guys, so before we get started, if you are new here, consider subscribing, put me on post notifications so that I don't miss any of my future goodies I have for you. We'll just start off by creating a new file. So click here, I'm using PyCharm, create a new Python file, and we'll name this file game, or let's give it Dino Game. So guys, the codes and all the files we use in this tutorial will be on my GitHub repository. We are not going to install anything now because I'll put all the requirements, the libraries we use here in a requirement.txt file on my GitHub as well. So you can just go there and leverage it and install all the requirements and use it. So we'll start off by importing the libraries we need for this. Alright guys, so these are the libraries we'll be using in this particular tutorial. We'll be using OpenCV to get our feed from the camera. We use the CV zone library. From the CV zone library, we'll get our hand detector. So that's what we'll be using to detect our hands, which is pretty much very easy for hand detection. And also we use the Pi Auto GUI library for pressing our keyboard or for doing some automatic keyboard and mouse click stuffs. So now that we are done with our imports, the next step is to go ahead and get our feed from the camera. And we have done this ton of times in other tutorials, so I will just go ahead. Alright guys, so this is the bare minimum code you need as well to open your webcam. So create a capture object, and here you insert your camera index here. So if you have multiple cameras, try from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on to get the right camera to work with. But if you are using only one camera with your computer or your computer camera, I think put in 0 here and you'll be fine. Then from there, we create a while loop because we know videos are just stack of images together. So we'll be taking them frame by frame. So to get our video, we use the frame equals cap.read. It returns another variable, which is a boolean we don't need now. So we are interested in a frame. After grabbing this frame, we just went ahead and show it using the imshow function. And then we wait for each second for new frame. And that's all. So we'll go ahead and run this to see whether we'll get a live feed from our webcam. Hey guys, and here you can see me in your webcam, so I'm live here and I'm glad to be doing this tutorial with you. But you can see now the picture is very small, so you should go ahead and resize this. The webcam feed is small, the output is small, so let's resize this as quick as possible. So we can come here and we say okay, we want to resize this, so our frame is also equal to the same frame. Oh, it's not. Is it equal to CV2.resize? And then we have to give it our frame and the size we want it. So let's do this 1080 by 720. I think that would be fine. And that's all. So I'll run this once again. Yeah, so it's much bigger now. You can see me, it's much bigger now. Our frame is much bigger now. Okay, so the whole concept of hacking the Dino game is that we first now track our hand, and then we find the distance between these two fingers, the thumb and the pinky finger. We find the distance. So anytime this distance here decreases, we'll just write the code to press the keyboard, the space button, or no, the navigation app button. Then the Dino game will jump, and that's if the Dino game My bad, the Dino game have seen an object in front of it. So anytime it has seen an object in front of it, and we close these two fingers together, then we expect it to jump. So that's the whole concept, and it's not a big deal, something we just do right now. So let's go ahead and get our hand tracking working. Then after that, we can apply the distance to press our keyboard. So let's go ahead and do that. So now to get a hand tracking working, we have to create a hand detector object. So let's call this HD, which is equal to our hand tracker, our hand detector. We can specify some arguments here. I think the max hands, let's put it one because we are using one hand, and we leave the other stuff as default. So to get your hand detection working, just come here and say okay, HD is equal to our HD.findHands, that's all, and then you give it our frame, and that's it. So this returns two things for you. It seems to return you with your image, which will take as our frame, and then to return your hand. So this is all we need, and if we should run this now, which we will do, our hand detection will be on. Okay, so we got an error somewhere, line 16. Oh, okay, so it seems I've interchanged this. It returns the hand and the frame, so we are putting the hand value to be displayed, which is not compatible with OpenCV. It only displays the NumPy array. So let's run this once again. Okay, so I raise my hand and the right hand is detected. Wow, just as simple as this, you can do hand detection. I raise this and it's also detected as well. Okay, so what we'll go ahead and do now is that we'll check if we are detecting any hand. Then when we are detecting any hand, we'll go ahead and extract the landmark list on this hand. So we'll extract all the landmark list on the line to get all the points, but we are interested in these two points. These two, the point at the thumb and the point at the pinky finger here. Then when we get these points, we'll find the distance between these two points, and then that's it. So let's go ahead and do that. Close this up, and we'll first check if we are getting hand. So we'll say if there is hand. If there is hand, then our hands is equal to the same hand at the in the zero, and then we can go ahead and get our landmark list. So we'll call it LM list, which stands for landmark list, is equal to our hands in the key of LM list. So it's a dictionary LM list. I think this is it. Then we can go ahead and print this list to see what we'll get. Okay, so before that, I can raise this up, bring back my face on the screen, and you can see nothing is popping up here. Nothing is printing on the terminal. Immediately I bring my hand, you can see we are getting the all the landmarks on the hand. So this is working fine. So now we have to continue with extracting the points we are interested in, then we'll work with these points. So that's our next step to do. Let's check that out. So we can comment this up here, and we'll say okay, our AG dot find distance, then this takes in the point at which you want to find the distance. So if you open the media pipe website and you search for the hand landmarks, you can see clearly that the point for the thumb and the pinky finger is 4 and 8. So we are going to use these points, extract only these points, because we are not interested in the other points of the fingers. We are only interested in the thumb and the pinky finger. So we are going to extract those points only. So to do that, we can say okay, we want to extract the LM list at index 4, my bad, and we'll slice this from 0 to 2. We are going to do same for the other finger too. So copy this and paste here and just change the numbers. So now it will be 8 here. And that's it. And the next thing we'll give it is to give it our frame. And this returns 3 other stuffs. It returns you with your length. Am I spelling length correctly? Also gives you the info about whatever you are doing. And the last one is it returns back your frame because you are giving it your frame. And that's it. So with this, you can get the length between those two fingers. So go ahead and print the length and see what we'll get. Okay, so I'll bring this back on and then put here, and you can see we are having some values. So if I'm closing it up, you can see the value becomes very small when I open, while the value changes. So now that's the length between these two fingers. So we are going to use this length to press, then we control the dino. But then whenever we see an object, we just click here and the bot jumps. So that's pretty much what we're doing. It's a computer vision hack, I may call it. So I'll close this up now and we'll write the condition to do that. I think first we have to round the length. So we can say length is equal to round, then we round length. Then what we'll do is that anytime the length is lower than the some threshold value, we'll press the up button. So we can say if our length is less than or equal to, no, let's just use less than some value. So anytime it's less than, let's say 40, we are going to press, and to press we use this library we've imported here, py auto GUI. So we can just say auto dot press and we'll pass in string value here, that up. So anytime this length is lower, the distance between these two fingers is lower, we are going to press, and we are going to press the up key, navigation up key, and that's it. So I'll run this up right away, and this is in. So let's see whether it's pressing. So you can see when I press there is some delay, and I think this is working. So what we'll do here now is to write on the top of the screen that okay, we are doing a dino hack. Then after that, we'll apply this to our game. So let's do that quick. So for that, we'll come at the top here and we'll put it here, CV zone, want to get a 9 test dot put text rectangle, and this will be on our frame. We want to put that we are doing a dino game hack. Then the position, we are putting this as 360 and 40. You can specify the scale. To be 3 and the thickness to be 3 as well. Then give it a border of 2. I think that will be fine. And then instead of the threshold being 40, we can make it 25, not to be too sensitive. So I think this will be fine. Anytime it's less than 25, we'll press. And now we'll run this up. Okay, so this working dino game hack, that's fine. So finally, let's apply this to our game. I'll open the game here, which is running already. So I'll place my feed here and let's get started. So just bring in my hand like this and I press. So you can see anytime I close the distance, it's going. No, I couldn't jump. Let's go. I'm not good in playing this. Let's go. Okay, it works. It works. Ah, here we go, guys. This is working. Off once again. Let me try once again the last time. Wow. Oh, no. So, guys, this is literally how we can hack the Dino game using computer vision. And it's good. Guys, so this is all I want to teach you in this tutorial. I think you've learned something new. If this is helpful, kindly share with your friends and also give me a thumbs up. And that's it. So I'll see you guys right in the next tutorial.